Well, we have breaking news leading the news at 9, and Victoria hitting another grim record. 473 new cases, marking the state's biggest surge in COVID cases this outbreak. Today, Melbourne reporter Christina Hearn leads our coverage from Fitzroy North. Chris, what do we know about these latest cases?
Well, Ali, our case numbers dipped to the high 300s yesterday, but now they are right back up there, 473. And of those numbers, only 202 are linked. It comes as fresh controversy surrounds this Fitzroy Community School where I am this morning. It was in the headlines last year for breaking lockdown rules. And now, reportedly, the principal has emailed parents in July encouraging them to send their children to school in direct breach of the chief health officer's orders. Now, we have spoken on the phone to Tim Berryman, the principal, a short time ago. He doesn't have COVID, but his son does. The family is in isolation and he denies that they have broken the chief health officer's orders. His mother and founder of this school, Faye Berryman, spoke to us through an isolation window a short time ago.
They may have a strong resilience to COVID, but they may not have a strong resilience to the upbringing being inflicted on them at the moment.
So she was certainly defending the school's position then. It will be interesting to see how the Victorian government reacts to their ongoing stance. There is also a continuing battle between the Victorian government and the Commonwealth. You might remember yesterday, the Premier, Daniel Andrews, said he was blindsided by the announcement that the federal government was sending an extra 400,000 doses of Pfizer and Moderna to the state. Well, the Task Force COVID Commander, Lieutenant General John Frewen, denies that and says they've been in constant communication with Victoria. Ali.
All right, there's a breakdown there somewhere. Thank you, Chris.